गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. वी आर सॉल्विंग द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर. इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद दैट द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4B, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4B, डिराइव द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर कैपेसिटर, फॉर कैपेसिटर ऑफ अ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर, ऑफ ए पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर, पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर कंटेनिंग टू डायलेक्ट्रिक्स, कंटेनिंग टू डायलेक्ट्रिक्स, राइट. डिराइव द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर कैपेसिटर ऑफ अ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर कंटेनिंग टू डायलेक्ट्रिक्स. लेट अस कंसिडर टू प्लेट्स हियर. लेट अस कंसिडर टू प्लेट्स हियर. So this is one plate, then we have the interface, then we have the interface here. This is the second plate, bottom plate. So this is in medium epsilon 1, this is an epsilon 2, this is distance at d1, this is at distance d2 distance, right. Area of the plates is A. This is plate 1, this is plate 1, and this is plate 1 and plate 2. We can have either of them, and the distance between the plates is d. Distance between the plates is d, right. So space between the plates is filled with more than one dielectric, fine. So it is a composite capacitor with space filled with two separate dielectrics for distances d1 and d2. The dielectric interface is parallel to the conducting plates. Space d1 is filled with dielectric of permittivity epsilon 1, while d2 is filled with epsilon 2, fine. So this is just the introduction. Then we have here Q as charge on each plate, charge on each plate, charge on each plate. Then E1 is field intensity in region D1. E2 bar is field intensity in region D2. As both the intensities are uniform, we have both intensities are uniform, right. So as both the intensities are uniform, we have V1 is equal to E1 D1, V2 is equal to E2 D2, because we know that E is equal to V by D, or V1 is equal to E1 D1, V2 is equal to E2 D2, where E1 and E2 are magnitudes of two intensities, therefore what will be the total V? Total V will be equal to V1 plus V2, that is E1 D1 plus E2 D2, take it as equation 1. So at the dielectric interface, the normal components of flux densities, right, at the dielectric interface here, the normal components of flux densities, that is dn1 and dn2 are equal. So at this interface here, the normal components of the two medium, that is dn1 and dn2 are equal, so therefore we have, because they are at the dielectric interface, so normal components will be equal, therefore we have dn1. Okay, so here just we saw here, so Q is the charge on each plate, E1 is field intensity in region D1, E2 is the field intensity in region D2, both intensities are uniform, so we have V1 is equal to E1 D1, V2 is equal to E2 D2. Total potential will be V1 plus V2, that is E1 D1 plus E2 D2, equation 1. Then we have dN1 is equal to dN2, normal component of both the medium will be equal. So if we substitute this in equation 1, that is we have d1 1, what is d1 then? D1 is equal to epsilon 1 e1, d1 is equal to epsilon 1 e1, right, and d2 will be equal to, or dn2 will be equal to epsilon 2 e2. D1 is equal to epsilon 1 e1, d2 is equal to epsilon 2 e2. So putting this in equation 1, so what is e1? E1 will be d1 by epsilon 1, e2 will be d2 by epsilon 2. So if you substitute this in equation 1, then we have here then we have, so we get V is equal to d1 by epsilon 1 d1 plus d2 by epsilon 2 d2. Take it as equation 2. So magnitude of surface charge is same on each plate. Magnitude of surface charge is same on each plate because they are identical surfaces. So magnitude of surface charge will be same on each plate. So we have rho s is equal to d1, that is equal to d2. Rho s is the surface charge density, that is charge upon area. So this d1 is nothing but flux density, that is flux upon area. So charge and flux both are identical here. So we have rho s is equal to d1, d1 is equal to d2, right? Then rho s will be equal to q by a, that is charge upon area, and d is also equal to charge or flux upon area. So as q and a both are same, so we have rho s is equal to d1 is equal to d2. Fine, students. Now put this in equation 2. So if you put this in equation 2, what we get? Yes, v is equal to rho s. So rho s is equal to d1 is equal to d2. So rho s d1 by epsilon 1 plus rho s d2 by epsilon 2. So take rho s common. So we have rho s is into d1 upon epsilon 1 plus d2 upon epsilon 2. So this is our v, right? So take this as our equation number. So d1 is equal to d2, take it as 3, and this as 4. This is equation 4. So v is equal to rho s into d1 upon epsilon 1 plus d2 upon epsilon 2. What is c? C is equal to q by v. That is q divided by v is rho s into d1 upon epsilon 1 plus d2 upon epsilon 2. But what is rho s into a? So we know that rho s is nothing but q by a, or rho s is equal to So we have here v is equal to rho s into d1 by epsilon 1 plus d2 by epsilon 2. C is equal to q by v, or q is q divided by rho s into d1 by epsilon 1 plus d2 by epsilon 2. So rho s is equal to, rho s is given by, rho s is q by a, or rho s into a, is equal to q. Here. So now substitute this here. So what we get, if you substitute this in our previous equation, so we get here c is equal to, therefore c is equal to rho s a. So wherever it is q, substitute as rho s a. This divided by rho s into d1 by epsilon 1 plus d2 by epsilon 2. So this is rho s, and rho s will cancel. So we get a divided by d1 upon epsilon 1 plus d2 upon epsilon 2. So take it as equation 5. Therefore we get c is equal to 1 divided by d1 upon epsilon 1 plus d2 upon epsilon 2 into 1 upon a. So a I will take to the denominator of the denominator. So if it comes, it will be multiplied by 1 by a. Okay, so this will be equal to 1 upon d1 by epsilon 1 a plus d2 by epsilon 2 a. So therefore we have c is equal to 1 upon c1 plus 1 upon c2. So take it as equation 6. Here. Right? Because c1 is what? C1 is epsilon 1 a by d1, and c2 is epsilon 2 a by d2. Therefore we have c is equal to 1 over c1 plus 1 by c2. Hence for n dielectrics in general, or we can generalize the above equation from equation 5, we can write, okay, so from equation 5 we can generalize it and write it as c is equal to a divided by d1 upon epsilon 1 plus d2 upon epsilon 2 plus and so on up till dn upon epsilon n, right? So this equation is 6, take it as equation 7. So this is our generalized equation where we have C is equal to A over D1 upon epsilon 1 plus D2 by epsilon 2 plus and so on up till Dn upon epsilon n. Okay, so this is the equation for the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor containing two dielectrics. Note that it is for two dielectrics, right? We have to be very much sure here that it is containing two dielectrics, and we are deriving the equation for the capacitance of such a capacitor. And then we have generalized that as C is equal to A divided by, we have derived and we have generalized it as C is equal to A divided by D1 upon epsilon 1 plus D2 upon epsilon 2 plus and so on up till Dn upon epsilon n. Right, students? So I hope you all have understood this derivation. If there are any doubts in this derivation, let me know. I'll clarify your doubts. Right? Thank you.